Hello, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls of all ages. Welcome to this edition of the RV Bandwagon. Today, we continue our coverage of the 2018 Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta. We have left the Black Mesa Casino RV Park and are headed south on I-25 towards the Fiesta grounds. Our day starts early as official media for this event. Some days have been extremely early. Today, not so bad. But as you can see here, there are thunderstorms on the horizon. Weather has played a big role in every aspect of this event, and today is no exception. We actually had the chance to sleep in just a little bit this morning, knowing that most of the events would either be canceled or postponed. Only being scheduled to attend the event for a few days, we would cover whatever we could with whatever weather we were given. I had a whole checklist of things I wanted to get filmed during this event, and I was eager to get it done. After the vicious fight through traffic and making our way to the parking area, one of the funnest things we found to do was to take a first-class, chauffeur-driven golf cart ride through the grounds and then over to the media tent. This was our view from the back seat as we were paraded through the grounds like royalty. But as usual, we were nobody special, as most everybody could get a ride on one of these courtesy shuttles. Nonetheless, it did make me feel pretty good as people gawked at me with my strange camera equipment. The courtesy rides also saved a little wear and tear on my tootsies. And they made Christy feel better because the wind was blowing in her hair and she didn't have to walk as far. And one big lesson we learned early in the game is that there's a lot of walking involved when it comes to being media at this event. We definitely like to give a big hats off to all the drivers out there who were so much fun and gave us a ride pretty much whenever we wanted one. As it turns out, these courtesy carts and their drivers were one of the coolest parts of the whole Balloon Fiesta for me. We definitely had some interesting rides and some awesome conversation with the drivers. If you ever make it out here, make sure you get aboard one of these cool little carts and talk to the driver. You just never know what you might learn about the Balloon Fiesta.
And we just tap. Chip. There we go.
Oh my God, it actually worked?
Yeah, that's it. That's it. And then the gentleman.
Once you get out the cart, it's time to go through security and they're going to check your RFID badge.
Allowed.
Awesome, they let me
welcome
in.
Welcome!
Once you're approved for entry, the media tower is on the left and the tent is right in front of us. This is also known as the Media Information Center. It's a nice enclosed private area they set up for media and guests. The tent features several televisions, refreshments, air conditioning, and heat if you need it. There is also a Hollywood-style placard for pictures like this. As a media participant, this tent is where you'll first show up to get your media kit. From there on out, this tent will basically be your home base while you're here at the media grounds. With our Balloon Fiesta credentials, we were able to get into the media tent to meet interesting people, to have breakfast and dinner on the weekends, snacks and drinks all throughout the week, and to use the area as an area for conversations and meetings with our clients and interviewees. The media tent was also a great place to pick up some high-quality Wi-Fi. Although having access to most areas, the corporate village was one area we just couldn't get into. These areas were reserved for the upper echelon of the corporately reserved, or something like that. We flashed around our credentials, but we couldn't get the security to budge. From what we could see, there was no celebrities in there, just a few guys playing some smooth jazz. One thing we found out for sure about this area is we weren't allowed. Most of the other areas at Fiesta Park, we definitely had access to. We were able to collect a tremendous amount of video footage from most every aspect of this event. Sometimes getting quality footage could be daunting because of the huge crowds who attend the event. It can be a challenge to capture events that happen simultaneously because the event grounds are so large. Getting to different areas means a whole lot of walking, and that can be a huge challenge. And sometimes it could be tough getting good footage because your credentials just aren't good enough.
Different aspects, and you guys are like the sponsors. Would you like to say anything on the video? Simple, if you're having fun, if you're not, selling any cameras, I don't know, whatever. If you're interested, it would be really great.
You might want to talk to Delicious here.
If they're busy, I don't want to bug them too bad, but you know, if you have a few moments, it's always cool.
The fact is, you're going to be doing a lot of asking and asking a lot of people a lot of questions to find out who you might want to talk to. And the fact is, even though you're looking at the person who you might want to be talking to, you're probably not going to be able to talk to them right away.
If you happen to find someone, I'm sure I can talk to these guys.
And if you can't get it figured out there, you just move on.
I'm Scott, I'm with RV Bandwagon War Media for the show. I was just wondering if I could get a little bit, a few works to put on the video we're making. There's me right there.
Hi, can I help you?
Yeah, I'm with the media, and I was interested in getting a few words from you guys.
No.
Well, sometimes you'll get the interview, and sometimes you won't, but the one big thing I told you about earlier is the weather will always decide your fate out here at the International Balloon Fiesta. And another thing you can count on for sure is that that weather will change as quick as it came. But no matter what, as media folk, you're going to be out there walking the turf and doing a lot of it. All in all, I've got to say that participating in the media event at the 2018 Albuquerque International Balloon Fiesta was freaking awesome. We sure did learn a lot, and we met a lot of great people, and we pulled out quite a few awesome stories. But out of all these stories, there's one big story we haven't told yet. And that's all about my first flight in a balloon gondola. I was able to take a balloon flight during mass ascension, and I'm going to take you right along with me. Thank you guys for watching. You have made our day.